Hello, welcome to this review of AI Frame Catalyst. Now, the video on the left is an original video, and the video on the right has been repurposed using AI Frame Catalyst, and I've used this face in the middle between the videos as input for AI Frame Catalyst. So you can see Mr. Potato Jet has been made to look like the face. So this is really interesting technology. The video output seems to work very well, but there is a catch. So I'm going to talk about that in a moment. So I'm in AI Frame Catalyst, and AI Frame Catalyst cost me $15 of my own money. I paid for this myself, so my views are my own. So you can see this video, I made this video 2 days ago. It took 2 days to make, and there's another problem that I'm going to talk about at the end of the video. So let's look at how we make a video. So we go to create a project within the creator menu. We need to give this a title. So our title will be BB. And we can either add a source image from a file, from camera, or from a gallery. I'm going to upload my own image, and it's going to be this face from before. So this face is actually an AI generated face. So it's not a real person. So I'm using that. And I'm going to click continue. And now we need to add a target. So we can go and add our own video. We can get one from YouTube, or we can get a stock video. So I'm going to go to YouTube. So here we have True Lies. So I'm going to click use this. It's a shame you can't submit your own URL. And here we've got face analysis age. It's going to be an adult. It's male. And I'm just going to leave it on reference. So I click submit. Now it tells me that it's been submitted successfully, and it can take anywhere between 30 minutes and 24 hours, depending how busy they are. So what's the big problem with AI Frame Catalyst? It looks like it works really well. The problem is not that I waited 2 days to get the output, but I think the big problem with this is the resolution is really very, very low. The resolution of my output video is 640 by 360. Which is incredibly low when you consider this video was available on YouTube up to 4K. So I did take this video from YouTube using the same method as before. It's available up to 4K, but it came out as 640 by 360. So I think that and the really slow render time stop this being really good. Thank you. Goodbye.